What's new in Angular 18? Angular 18 has arrived packed with new features, enhancements, and some breaking changes that every developer should be aware of. The new release graduates several features from developer preview to stable release, which makes development smoother and reduces the likelihood of runtime errors. In this video, I'll dive into the key updates and explain how they can improve your Angular applications and streamline your development process. New features. Defer is stable. One of the most anticipated features, Defer, is now stable. This decorator helps in deferring the loading of components and makes your application faster and more responsive. It's a great way to optimize load times by prioritizing critical components. Build.com has reduced the bundle size of one of their web apps by 50% using deferable views. Control flow is stable. The control flow is now stable. This provides a more predictable and efficient way to handle complex logic in web apps. This feature ensures that your code runs smoothly, even when dealing with intricate control structures. Enhanced form API. One of the standout features of Angular 18 is the improved Forms API. This update simplifies reactive forms, making them more intuitive and easier to manage. The new API provides better type safety and enhanced validation capabilities. This streamlined approach reduces boilerplate code and makes form validation more robust and easier to implement. Type narrowing of signals. Type narrowing of signals enhances type safety in Angular applications. With this improvement, you can write more precise and error-free code by leveraging TypeScript's powerful type-checking capabilities. Zoneless change detection. Angular 18 introduces zoneless change detection, which significantly improves performance by eliminating the need for ZoneJS in specific scenarios. This change is particularly beneficial for large-scale applications with complex change detection requirements. Change detection scheduler in zone applications. The scheduler in Angular's change detection mechanism orchestrates when and how change detection cycles are triggered to ensure the UI stays in sync with the application's data model. The new change detection scheduler in zone applications provides a more efficient way to manage change detection. This reduces the performance overhead and makes applications more responsive. Zone coalescing by default. Zone coalescing refers to the optimization technique that reduces the number of change detection cycles triggered by multiple events happening within a short time frame. This technique is relevant when dealing with event-heavy templates or frequent state changes in Angular applications. Zone coalescing is now enabled by default, which means Angular will automatically optimize the scheduling of change detection cycles. This leads to better performance and smoother user experience. Component support for zoneless. Component support for zoneless change detection means that you can now create components that don't rely on ZoneJS. This would further optimize performance and simplify the development process. Model inputs. Angular 18 introduces enhanced support for model inputs, which provides a more intuitive way to handle input data binding and validation. Defining a model input is a bit similar to creating a standard input. Both allow you to bind the value into the property. However, with the model input, you can write values into the property. A standard input is read-only, while a model input is two-way data binding, so that you can write directly to it. Default content for NG content. The ability to provide default content for NG content ensures that components remains functional even when projected content is missing. This feature is useful for creating more resilient components that can handle missing or incomplete content gracefully. It allows you also to avoid duplicated code. In this example, though app component doesn't provide content for the header section, when it uses the main layout component, the output of rendering the app component on the browser would be hello again, custom main content, or rights reserved. Unified control state change events. The forms module in Angular 18 now includes unified control state change events. This feature makes it easier to manage form state and validation. When you subscribe to the events observable on abstract control, you can get four distinct types of events, which are an extension of control event. Status event, it reflects the current status of the form control and has status property. Pristine event, it's when the control has been interacted with, it has pristine property. Touched event, it's when the control is touched and has touched property. Value change event, returns the updated value of the control. It has value property. Routing. New redirect command. The new version of Angular introduced the new redirect command class created to manage navigation extras. This improvement leads to enhanced Angular redirection abilities with guards and resolvers. Redirect command class makes it easier for developers to handle challenging navigation patterns in Angular applications. In Angular, the skip location change option, when set to true, allows navigation to occur without changing the browser's URL. This means the navigation will happen internally and the URL in the address bar will remain the same as before the navigation. This is helpful for scenarios where you want to update the view without affecting the browser's history or the displayed URL, such as in cases of handling error states without showing the error URL. Routing. Root redirects as functions. In Angular 18, the redirect property within the root's configuration has been enhanced to accept a function that returns a string. With this change, you can implement more sophisticated logic for determining the target root based on various conditions, including runtime states. Previously, the redirect property could only specify a specific string representing the path to redirect to. Routing. Parameterized route for static site generation. The support of parameterized routes in static site generation, or SSG, is a boon for developers looking to leverage Angular for static site generation. This is helpful for dynamic and SEO-friendly static sites. Hydrated internationalization blocks in SSR mode. The collaboration with Aurora has brought hydration support for I18N blocks. This enhances internationalization in server-side rendered or SSR applications. For that sake, you can use provide client hydration with I18N support. This feature ensures that translations are rendered correctly on the server, which reduces the time to first paint, or TTFP. Partial hydration. Partial hydration allows for more efficient server-side rendering by only hydrating parts of the DOM that need it. This results in faster initial load times and better user experience. Event replay during hydration. Event replay during hydration mimics the behavior of JS action. It provides a smoother and more responsive user experience by replaying user actions after hydration. Optional migration to application builder. Angular 18 includes a prompt optional migration to the new application builder. This streamlines the build process and offers improved build performance and flexibility. Optional Webpack dependency. Webpack is now an optional dependency. Developers can choose their preferred build tools without being tied to Webpack. This flexibility makes it easier to integrate Angular with various build systems. Support of TypeScript 5.04. Angular 18 is now compatible exclusively with TypeScript 5.04. This upgrade ensures that developers can leverage the latest TypeScript features and improvements for better type safety and developer experience. Breaking changes. Angular 18 also comes with a few breaking changes that you should be aware of. Several deprecated APIs have been removed in Angular 18, so you need to review your code base and update any usage of these APIs to ensure compatibility with the new version. Use the new APIs provided by Angular 18 to achieve similar functionality. If your application relies heavily on forms, ensure you test these changes thoroughly. There are changes in the forms module, specifically around form control status and validation. These changes aim to make your applications more robust and user-friendly. Enhanced debugging tools. Angular 18 includes enhanced debugging tools that offer deeper insights into application state and performance. The updated Angular DevTools extension provides new features for profiling and debugging, which makes it easier to identify and fix issues in your applications. Performance enhancements. Angular 18 includes numerous performance enhancements, such as faster compilation time and improved change detection. This improvement ensures that web apps run faster and more efficiently. Bug fixes. This release also addresses several bugs reported by the community. These fixes improve the stability and reliability of the framework. Angular 18 is a significant release that brings a host of new features, performance improvements, and important changes. Whether you are building new applications or maintaining existing ones, make sure to upgrade to the new version to take advantage of the latest advancements in web development. Don't miss out on these exciting updates. You can find more details on the Angular changelog page on GitHub. For more updates and tech insights, make sure to subscribe to my newsletter where I share free access to my video courses. If you liked the video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. That's it for today, and see you next time.